true power.
Ladies and gents, we are back with another dose of awesomeness here on the Exploder Strategies. Now, this is where we left off. We left off Squinrusher dealing with the rest of Bob's base with his mighty tripods with that very special EMP ability. If you want to know how to gain that ability with the Reaper 17 tripods, don't talk to me. Talk to Squinrusher. And if you want to talk to Squinrusher, give me a message and I'll send you a link to his YouTube page, and you can even comment on there, you can subscribe to him, you can be his mate, you can, well, do whatever you want, just ask him if you're curious, you know. But he hasn't defeated Bob yet, because Bob has that one outpost left. Squinrusher notices, and he will go out to destroy. In the meantime, my Enlightened are still just EMPing the base continuously. And there you go. Bob's down. And all those troops are dead. That's one down. Congratulations, Squinrusher, for getting the win. And as soon as Bob goes down, that's when the mighty Fred comes into action and starts sending a mahoosive wave straight at Killer's expansion base near that blue tip field to the north. Hopefully he can survive through it. I know he can survive through it because, well, he's a very keen dude and he knows what he's doing. And he sends that one commando backed up by that watchtower that he's dealing with damage. He's poning a lot. He's gonna get rid of those infantry units, and even an EMP barrage stops those scorpions from going any further. Well done, Commando, and well done, Killer. You get a tick. Oh yeah. And here come the Grenadier APCs to the rescue to deal the damage on the remaining scorpion tanks. Now, as you can see, those APCs, Grenadiers, are very good to take out these types of groups of tanks. Mainly because those grenades have splash damage on a certain radius, and so they can do quite a lot of damage. As you can see, there's an EMP blast there. And here come the buggies, which means one thing. EMP! Now, if there's one graphic I did absolutely love in this game, it had to be the buggy EMP. Very different from the main EMP, and if it had a ton of raider buggies queued up to do the EMP, it looks absolutely beautiful, in my personal view. Absolutely beautiful. As you can see here, my Enlightened are dealing the damage on an enemy conyard and destroys it. Because now my plan of action is to use the buggies to EMP and my Enlightened to destroy everything. And here's an orbital strike. No, sorry, orbital bombardment. And there's another series of EMPs from my lovely, lovely raider buggies. And I think another one's going to be coming in a minute. There you go, another power plant base is just, oh, there you go, another one hits. Another power plant's getting shot at. By this moment in time, all my Enlightened squads were actually heroic. By taking out these buildings and taking out units during the course of the game. So this was very good for my Enlightened troops, because they could take out structures. If they were in decent groups, they could take out those structures with ease. And there was a Tiberium vein detonation on Thingamadoodle's base, using my Tiberium vein detonation, which I didn't mind using at all. And even more raider buggies come now. I had originally queued up like 20 raider buggies, just because the more you have, and like, yeah, the more you have, and especially if they're closer together, and as soon as you select them all, make sure that you put them so that they're all close together, and then activate the EMP, that's when it looks really badass. And as I have to just say, EA did a brilliant job of that. They really did. I personally thought that had to be one of the best graphics in this game, the buggies doing the EMP. That had to be absolutely brill, in my personal view. If you guys have your own view about it, just give me a bell. And as you see, Overlord's Wrath. Haha. And even more EMPs. Which means that killers, Grenadier APCs have been emptied, so his grenadiers have obviously ran up there, used EMP grenades, and yep, they're back. But look, Killer's base could be in danger, but it isn't, because Killer's too good for that. Oh yeah. And here's me thinking, okay, have I taken out every building? No, I haven't, because there's that one left. But we're leaving that one for a special, well, very special treat at the end of this very nice strat. You'll see what I mean. Now the three of us are mainly going to concentrate on this mini expansion here. That expansion has quite a lot of defenses, it will be very annoying, and Killer's sending in zone raiders, which are excuse me about that. Whoa. Now, as I said, he's sending in zone raiders, which are doing the job really well. And that's when I'm like, okay, I think he needs help with those base defenses. So I'm like, okay, let's bring in the buggies. The first time I tried to set up the buggies, for some strange reason, only some of them went and they didn't activate their EMPs like I asked them to. So I'm just like, okay, select them again, do it again. They go around the power plants of the base defenses, they activate their lovely EMP, shutting off all the base defenses, allowing for Killer to just go in there and wipe out everything with his zone raiders, which were heroic at this moment in time. So that's cool. But for some strange reason, he wasn't really destroying the base defenses, or even the power plants. And I was like, okay, I'll do this myself. So that's when I was gonna get my Enlightened selected, and they were gonna come and see if they could help out destroy that thing. Because, oh, here they come. Here come the Enlightened. Good thing is, there's a little thing that says when the Enlightened use their EMP abilities, their stationary for a certain amount of time. They're actually not. I think either the patch fixed that, or there was an improper input by EA on that, but according to, well, I got it from some source, but according to it, if you use the EMP with the Enlightened, they shut down for a certain amount of time and then they come back online, but they don't. It might be just because I've got supercharged particle beams and a couple of upgrades from the secret shrine. I'm not sure, but hey, if any of you guys can actually check on that, I'll be really pleased. Yeah, there's another mission for you guys now. Well, hey. And there you go, the base defenses are practically taken out by now. As you see, more of the lovely EMP abilities of the raider buggies coming in. The Enlightened doing their job. Ooh. Even more zone raiders being dropped off, and also some grenadiers with the EMP grenade abilities. And look, Skrinrusher sending in his absolutely massive army of tripods. Yay! As you see, another power plant go down. We have a couple of power plants up there with a couple of base defenses, which we're going to go up to next. As you can see, Skrinross has put a growth accelerator up there, just to prove to us that he could get a growth accelerator on every single tip field, which he successfully did. Doesn't get him a medal, but it's proven that he could do it. That's for sure. As you see, my raider buggy's EMP'd that area. Now Scrinrus is coming into the action with his mighty tripods. They're waiting. And we're doing a very good job waiting of that. So my Enlightened are going in for the kill, but those annoying rocket squads are just being, well, annoying. So I was like, okay, if you guys finish off these buildings, I'll finish off these rocket dudes. And just as soon as I finished actually destroying those power plants and start attacking those rocket dudes, I have now just realized that I can't actually continue. Because it will be concluded in part 3 with a mahoosive ending.